Free speech is meaningless unless you allow people you don't like to say things you don't like. Otherwise, it's irrelevant. And if at the point at which you lose free speech, it doesn't come back.
I think the issue some people have is that a lot of people were brought back. I mean, some people were brought back who were previously banned for spreading things like QAnon conspiracies. You have people like Andrew Tate who were brought back, who were previously banned for things like hate speech. Do you think you prioritize freedom of speech over misinformation and hate speech?
Well, you know, who's to say that something is misinformation? Who is the arbiter of that? Is it the BBC?
You're literally asking me.
Yes.
Well, no,
who is the arbiter?
You are the arbiter on Twitter because you own Twitter.
Yes, I'm saying who is to say that one person's misinformation is another person's information? The point at which you say that there is this is misinformation, like who is going to decide
that? But you accept that misinformation can be dangerous, that it can cause real world harms, that it can potentially cause...
Yeah, so the point I'm trying to make is that the BBC itself has at times published things that are false. Do you agree that that has occurred?
I'm quite sure the BBC have said things before that turn out to not be true.
Right.
In its, whatever it is, 100-year history, I'm quite sure.
Yes. Even if you aspire to be accurate, there are times when you will not be.
We've spoken to people very recently who were involved in moderation, and they just say there's not enough people to police this stuff, particularly around hate speech in the company.
What hate speech are you talking about? I mean, you use Twitter.
Right.
Do you see a rise in hate speech?
I mean,
just a personal anecdote. Like, what do you? I don't.
Personally, my For You, I would see I get more of that kind of content. Yeah, personally. But I'm not going to talk to the rest of for the rest of Twitter.
You see more hate speech personally.
I would say I would see more hateful content in that.
Content you don't like or hateful. What do you mean? To describe a hateful thing.
Yeah, I mean, you know, just content that will solicit a reaction, something that may include something that is slightly racist or slightly sexist, those kinds of things.
So you think if something is slightly sexist, it should be banned?
No, is that what you're saying? I'm not saying anything.
Well, I'm just curious. I'm trying to understand what you mean by hateful content. And I'm asking for specific examples. And you just said that if something is slightly sexist, that's hateful content. Does that mean that it should be banned?
Well, you've asked me whether my feed, whether it's got less or more. I'd say it's got slightly more.
That's why I'm asking for examples. Can you name one example?
I honestly don't. You can't name a single example. I'll tell you why, because I don't actually use that For You feed anymore because I just don't particularly like it.
But you
and
said
actually,
you...
a lot of people are quite similar. I only look at my following.
You said you've seen more hateful content, but you can't name a single example, not even one.
I'm not sure I've used that feed for the last 3 or 4 weeks.
Well, how did you see the hateful content?
Because I've been using Twitter since you've taken it over for the last 6 months.
Okay, so then you must have at some point seen that you For You hateful content. And I'm asking for one example.
Right.
And you can't give a single one.
And I'm saying that
you don't know what you're talking about.
Really?
Yes, because you can't give me a single example of hateful content, not even one tweet. And yet you claimed that the hateful content was high.
Well,
that's a false.
No, what I claimed.
You just lied.
What I claimed was. There are many organizations that say that that kind of information is on the rise. Now, whether it has on
Give
my feed
one
or
example.
Not, I mean, I, right, and
literally
if you
can't
look at
someone
like the Strategic Dialogue Institute in the UK, they will say that.
People will say all sorts of nonsense. I'm literally asking for a single example, and you can't name one.
Right, and as I already said, I don't use that feed. But let's,
then how would you know? That
I don't think this is getting anywhere.
You literally said you experienced more hateful content, and then couldn't name a single example.
Right, and as I said,
that's absurd.
I haven't actually looked at that feed.
Then how would you know this hateful content?
Because I'm saying that's what I saw a few weeks ago. I can't give you an exact example. Let's move on. We only have a certain amount of time. COVID misinformation. You changed the COVID misinformation.
Has BBC changed its COVID misinformation?
The BBC does not set the rules on Twitter, so I'm asking you.
No, I'm talking about the BBC's misinformation about COVID.
I'm literally asking you about, you changed the labels, the COVID misinformation labels. There used to be a policy, and then it disappeared. Why do that?
Well, COVID is no longer an issue. Does the BBC hold itself at all responsible for misinformation regarding masking and side effects of vaccinations and not reporting on that at all? And what about the fact that the BBC was put under pressure by the British government to change its editorial policy? Are you aware of that?
This is not an interview about the BBC.
Oh, so. You thought it wasn't?
I see now why you've done Twitter Spaces. I am not a representative of the BBC's editorial policy. I want to make that clear. Let's talk about something else.
I'm interviewing you too.
All right, let's talk about something else.